Love me as you've never loved
炎炎的非洲为全球第二大洲，有着令人难忘的气候、原始多变的生活环境，以及全球种类最丰富的野生动物区。大地之母的非洲为上帝眷顾恩宠之地，相传人类始祖即来自充满生机的非洲原野。非洲有绿意盎然的丛林、原始特殊的生态景观及蕴藏黄金、白金和钻石的绵延山脉，从东非蜿蜒流向北方的尼罗河，全长超过4000英里。尼罗河不仅是世界第一长河，也是埃及文明的灵魂和悠久历史的原动力。全球有许多神圣的山脉，如东方的喜马拉雅山、中东的西奈山以及中国的泰山，而在非洲也有许多世人不知晓的圣山，如当地著名的肯雅山脉，也被称为光明山或上帝之山。而非洲第一高峰吉利马扎罗山，其翠绿的山坡被视为上帝殿堂后方的阴地，其山顶则被视为灵魂最终的安息居所。死亡是生命中不可避免的过程，而在历史的轨迹中，一切也只是成住幻空。非洲曾经有过相当文明的盛况，也曾出现过许多著名的历史人物，如西巴女王、克里欧佩托拉王后以及阿比西尼亚国王美尼利克。曾经显赫一时的王朝，如今只剩残破的遗址或是零星的村庄部落，我们只能从流传下来的音乐舞蹈中怀念想象。而今日非洲多数国家经常面临战乱、饥荒、干旱等连绵不绝的天灾人祸，非洲子民如此遭遇，或许因为他们遗忘了自己是上帝的儿女，因此非洲50余国至今仍有不少种族过着部落形态的原始生活。然而即使在这一般艰苦的环境中，非洲人民仍坚强地为生存而奋斗，产生出无数优秀的非洲后裔。他们在世界各领域的表现的确令人敬佩效法。上帝的爱力也不断透过开悟的名师来加持非洲子民。1995年，青海无上师抵达西非的象牙海岸，该国第一夫人贝蒂女士特别邀请无上师前往总统府，热诚款待这位国宾。无上师在得知当地医院困境后，便立即为院方添购医疗用品、器材和药品。贝南王子 也陪同无上师到各孤儿院探访，随后青海无上师来到闻名古国卑南。卑南皇家成员特地在机场以盛大的欢迎仪式迎接这位国宾的到来。阿古丽国王伉俪也邀请无上师到王宫访问，以表达对无上师来访的万分荣幸之意。期间无上师也到当地的医院和村庄进行探访慰问，并且拜访了多所由修女创办的孤儿院，除了为院童带来礼物，更致上无限的关怀。无上师还捐款给圣婴耶稣孤儿院，帮助该院添购多项基本设施。临行前，卑南第一夫人索格罗女士特别感激无上师的爱心义举。西非访问结束后，吴上师还是一直惦念着当地孩童的生活情况，因此又添购了多项医疗用品运送给他们。卑南向阳海岸的居民收到救济物资后，都很感谢吴上师悲天悯人的胸怀，无微不至地将上帝的爱与世人分享。历年来，青海无上师和世界会会员们也经常透过红十字会和其他的慈善机构为急需援助的非洲灾民进行人道救援工作，如卢旺达内战的难民、饱尝旱灾的苏丹人民以及乌干达的救行团体。世界会会员也跟随青海无上师的脚步，积极投入各项赈灾活动，为受难的鳏寡孤独者带来及时的温暖与关怀。1999年12月，青海无上师再次抵达非洲，应邀出席本世纪最重要的盛会之一——世界宗教会议。为期八天的宗教大会在南非开普敦举行，与会者来自世界各地，超过数千人。各宗教领袖包括基督教、佛教、犹太教、伊斯兰教、印度教等及其他许多灵修导师，共同为世界和平祈福。开幕仪式中，大会主席特别邀请青海无上师这位世界精神领袖以贵宾身份带领大众做特别祷告。
Pray Lord, grant us some of the dignity of the basic peacefulness so that we may have enough calm, enough surrender to remember you every second of our life. Because you are glory, you are beauty, you are richness, you are the most fantastic vision of the perfection that we could ever remember. So let this perfection also be manifest on this planet. Keep your purity even though your possession is gone.
Thank you.
God is the best possession.
Thank you.
And our real home is in heaven. Tell your people. Everything is just a test, just a game, to see if we still remember God in face of trouble. Yes. And if we do,He rewards us multiple. The eternal protection is God. And our home is always there waiting for you. I know for sure. I promise. Africa.
1999年年底，在中东暨非洲巡回弘法期间，青海无上师也应邀在南非三大城市德尔班、约翰尼斯堡及开普敦展开巡回演讲，传播爱与和平的讯息。无上师的甘露法语滋润了无数真理渴慕者的心灵。弘法讲经结束后，来自全球20多国驻坚尼世界会会员们特别于南非举办了一场国际禅修活动，共同为世界和平祈福。无上师的南非之行不仅带给当地民众高尚的灵性教理，也为贫困无依者带来博爱的赈济关怀。 青海无上师拜访南非期间，当地及各国媒体也纷纷以大量篇幅报道这位著名精神领袖来访的盛世和他的爱心事迹，如金雨林、宗教大官、英国国家电视台、南非公共电视台 SABC 电视台和开普敦时报、人民之声、论坛先锋时报、水星商业报道、南非亚洲日报等，对无上师南非之行皆有深入的报道。以下请您一同观赏青海无上师在世界宗教会议发表演讲后，接受南非最大电视台 SABC 第一、第二台的访问片段。
Master, why did you choose to come to the Parliament of World Religions?
Because I'm invited to come here. Yes. And we should, every one of us, including myself, should support any activities that unite ourselves to ourselves. Yes, so we don't feel too much division and too much misunderstanding between each other. We have a chance to talk to each other. That is a good idea. So I came to support that noble idea. Yes.
And can you describe for us, or just sort of tell us, so that for people that don't understand and don't know about it, what the Kuan Yin method is, what it actually is all about?
Right. I started in Taiwan. And Kuan Yin is the Chinese term for the inner energy, the inner melody, the heavenly melody, which is mentioned in mentioned in the Bible as the Word of God. Yeah, the Word was with God and the Word was God. This is the Kuan Yin, and we reconnect ourselves with that energy, with that Word, which creates all things. And therefore we will become one with God, and we will understand our purpose of being here, as well as we can visit heaven and have direct teaching from the Most High.
So is it meditation, lifestyle, what is it, how does one live it?
Yeah, first we have to go through remembrance again. Right, because most of us are busy. Since we came to this physical world, we're busy. So then we have to remember again. And I show people how to remember their God self, that the kingdom of God within, and that we are a part of God. I will show the people how to remember. And in order to remember that, we sit down quietly for a while and let God power take place to reconnect himself to himself within us. And during that process, we will see the light of God, or we see some heaven, the glimpse of heaven, or the glimpse of Father, or have some direct contact with Him. It depends on our level of concentration. We will access to more or less contact with heaven through the light, through the sound, the vibration, the Word within us. Then we will understand more about everything we want to understand. And we can see God every day in different form, through the light or the music of the spirit, through the teaching, the melodious teaching of God, or through the form of Jesus, the vision of Jesus, or the saint, or the Buddha, who will give us direct teaching. While we ascend to this state of higher consciousness, we can contact them directly, because they are in a higher consciousness now. We are in the lower consciousness in this physical body. So in order to receive this direct teaching, we have to rise ourselves higher than the body, and we have the process to do that. If we remember how, we all know that. It's just many of us forgot. And I remember it. I've been taught to remember again. So that's how I can teach people to remember. And once we remember, we can rise up to heaven anytime, at will. And then we have direct teaching from the past saints like Jesus, Buddha, Mohammed, whomever. They're all the sons of God. They're all the messengers of the Most High since times immemorial.
And how did you come across this revelation?
Oh, I have been searching all my life. And then until I went to the Himalaya and met the master who gave me this remembering, reminding, yes. Just like I would remind people after I have mastered the art of, I would say, traveling to heaven.
And a lot of people talk about different religions that are sort of sexist, or
right.
They don't give equality to women, for example.
Yes, right.
A lot of people, that's quite a big issue at this parliament as well, the discussion of women and religion.
Right.
What is your feeling about that?
My opinion is exactly as yours, and as many and most of people in the world, is that we are all children of God. Jesus, Buddha, Mohammed has never mentioned that women are inferior or men should be superior, nothing like that. So we should keep it like that. Yes, every religion emphasizes the brotherhood of mankind. That includes women as well.
And we've heard that you go to places of suffering, places that have been hit by disasters, that kind of thing. Why
yes,
do
ma'am.
You go there?
You would go if you were me. If you have the means to help people, if God gives you more than you need, then you would go there and share the things you have with people, because that's what they are given to you for. Much is expected from whom much is given. God doesn't give it to me so that I can eat more or sleep more, but give it to me so I can share. Just like, you know, you have a big water tower in the city. It's not for the water tower to hold it there, but to share with the whole city. So I'm just one of the pipe, you know, that I will direct the water to where it's needed.
So we've heard about the donations, of who you gave it to, why.
Usually everywhere we go, whenever we have opportunity, we do that. But then nobody in my group know anything about these children. They came from Durban somewhere, suburban of Durban, very far away. They say they went on bus for 30 hours. They didn't sleep, they didn't eat anything. They come here and then they wanted to see me. So I came down and greet them, you know, hug them. And then I asked where they came from and what brought them there, and she told me about their plight. They didn't have school, they didn't have toilet, they didn't have water. Where they live is very, very deprived of the basic need of human dignity. I forgot the name of the village. I just gave and go. I don't remember. So please, I cannot tell you where it is and who they are. I don't even remember the village they came from.
And what about poverty?
Poverty is because we don't share. You asked me before why I go to disaster place or why I give my things, or my members also encouraged to give direct to people. They give all the time. We don't always... some of the thing, you know, we give is because it's official. But the unofficial things we give as daily basic, we give to people on the street, we stop the car at the red light, we give like children of today, because there was television there, so they saw it, otherwise they didn't see it. You see what I mean? Some official we give and some not official we give all the time. Because the question of poverty never would happen if all the people in the world share what they have. We have enough food, we have enough, more than enough of everything in this world to feed the whole planet. Plus over. It's just some keep too much. And some don't have the opportunity to get their share because of where they were born, because of their background. We manage through Red Cross or through other United Nations or through other organizations, we manage to get through to those brothers and sisters. But you see what I mean? Poverty is our self-handmade. God doesn't intend. God gives us so much, so much. Every one of us has enough, plus over. It's ourselves. We keep it from ourselves.
And who are the people that follow this teaching? How many are there? Where are they from? Are they? Are they from different religions?
There are millions of them. They're from different religions, different walks of life, different background, different professions. Yes. But when we are together, we are like one family.
are trusting, loving, and we together we harness this collective energy to better ourselves and better the world's energy.
世界宗教会议典礼活动中，祖鲁儿童舞蹈团孩童们的纯洁和诚挚，令清海无上师相当感动，所以他特别慷慨捐款，表达其关怀的心意。儿童们都非常感谢无上师的善心援助，于是诚心地邀请他担任第二天晚上表演活动的贵宾，欣赏他们精湛的演出。在隔天的表演会场上，宗教大会副主席回山女士也亲切地欢迎青海无上师的莅临。回山女士告诉无上师，该会设有儿童援助基金，帮助急需救助的非洲孩童，吴上师便义不容辞地提供捐款援助。这次南非之行，吴上师除了带给该国人民无限的祝福，更为贫苦无信民众带来福音。受助者除了祖鲁儿童舞蹈团外，帮助宗教会议与会儿童食宿、交通等费用，还有急需重建屋舍、排水系统的高萨族人及当地的孤儿院。青海无上师所到之处都受到非洲人民热烈欢迎，感谢他不辞辛劳地传扬和平与爱的讯息。南非儿童也以热情的舞蹈欢迎青海无上师这位荣誉贵宾。以下我们邀请您一同欣赏南非祖鲁儿童舞蹈团在世界宗教会议典礼上充满动感旋律及非洲色彩的精湛表演。
love me as you've never loved anyone.
青海不上师是一位知名的慈善家、艺术家及灵性导师，他的生命本身诠释了爱的真谛。多年以来，青海无上师的慈悲与爱心，透过慈善工作，已经触动了千万人的心灵。他不辞辛劳地走访世界各地，赞助各项公益活动，对于纾危解困的工作也总是不遗余力。青海无上师的爱心已遍及全世界六大洲，涵盖各国籍及各宗教背景的人士。
Whatever we can share, begin with sharing. And then we will feel a subtle change in ourselves. More love will be pouring into our consciousness. And we will be aware of something. And that is the beginning. We are here to learn. To learn to grow. As well as to learn to use our power. Our limitless power of love and creativity.In order to make a better world wherever we happen to be.
青海无上师也一向鼓励人们静心美化这个世界。透过修行观音法门，青海无上师将他内在开悟的体验表现于多方面的艺术才华，包括绘画、乐曲、诗歌创作、珠宝、服装设计等等。其作品融合各民族文化的内在美与外在美。1995年，应广大群众的请求，青海无上师的天衣服装秀在伦敦、巴黎、米兰、纽约等国际流行重镇盛大展出。青海无上师的诗作也由好莱坞及世界各国的音乐家谱成乐曲，分别在美国长堤、华盛顿特区和洛杉矶等地的慈善音乐会上发表。无上师用这些艺术创作的所得从事慈善工作，从这里我们可以见到他踏实的精神。人们应该自力更生，进而才能造福他人。
So this is from you to them.
虽然他向来不求任何个人的荣耀，但其无我奉献的精神仍然受到各国政府及私人团体的肯定。
She also brings love around the world where there is hate. She brings hope where there is despair.And she brings understanding where there is misunderstanding. She is the light of a great person, an angel of mercy for all of us.
经由青海无上师在世界各地的慈善工作，我们见识到无数发人深省的慈悲爱力，而这也正是这位善心女士和在他爱心感召下成立的世界会的标志。历年来，青海无上师世界会福尔摩沙会员及志工们在青海无上师无我奉献的感召下，今年不断地从事各项的慈善公益活动，帮助贫苦老人、孤儿、流浪汉、监狱受刑人，照顾偏远地区贫户、原住民等， 希望能将修行的爱心化为日常生活的行动，将希望和信心带给那些失意的人。为了与社会各阶层人士分享灵修生活化的创意，青海无上师世界会福尔摩沙会员也经常应各县市文艺部门邀请，在各地举办融合传统和现代的艺文表演活动与各项艺术创作展览，并于北中南各地定期举办老人及青少年素食夏令营，为一世代的英法族及年轻人培养健全的身心灵。
我们非常感谢长期以来他们禅定协会的所有会兄会姐能够以自己的行动来参与环保的这个运动，不只是环保，包括今天我们看到的这些这个无氧安瓶这么好的一个节目都是他们提供的，所以等于说跟社会各界打成一片，然后以实际的行动来造福整个人间来让大家可以跟他们非常的亲近这一点我们一直很肯定。我想他们灵修感受出来的爱心能够以真正生活化的动作，包括舞蹈歌曲来与民同乐让他们这种精神可以在大家同乐当中受到大家的肯定跟体会，意义非常的好，我们说是一种潜移默化教化社会的一种具体表现。
此外，微信环保一直是青海无上师重视的课题之一，观光海岸净滩、认养公路等定期环保工作十数年如一日，希望回复福尔摩沙原有的美丽面貌。青海无上师世界会常年以来默默致力于环保工作，也获得了福尔摩沙各界的肯定。
我们中华民国禅定协会长期的认养我们这条道路，把我们的年二十八线整理的可以说连一点土我都看不到，而且他们自己用他们的交通工具把我们的垃圾做分类，然后尘归尘土归土，把我们放置在比我们能够设想更周到。
如果要谈到感想的话，我想用两个字来形容：感动。特别是像这样的天后，然后下着小雨，吹着寒风，那我们禅定学会的所有的参与的这些会员，还有一些志工义工能够在这样的天候之下，还能够持续的进行这样一个净滩的活动，我想真的只能用感动来形容。
今天非常欢迎我们中华民国禅定学会，就是青海无上师的我们这个所有的会员。关心环保跟我们心灵改造的这个大问题。那么这个净滩运动到目前为止有六个团体是常态的来做一个主动配合部分计划的工作，那么其中每个两个礼拜去净滩一次，做的最有名、做的最固定、做的最彻底的、表现最好的就是我们中华民国禅定协会，所以我们才颁了这个公益奖给我们会单位。所以心灵的改造从环保做起无形的修持从有形的行动一点一滴累积从这个这样一个有看到的事物来出发，我都相当的认同。
青海无上师除了教导人们寻求内在的开悟与和平，也不忘提醒每个人要尽好世界公民的责任，随时帮助扶持需要帮助的人。921地震和那莉风灾期间，世界会会员的积极救援行动充分表达了青海无上师对福尔摩沙人民的关爱。我想借此提醒福尔摩沙所有的小中心要组织起来，对灾民给予援助，帮助你们陷于困难中的同胞以及各阶层的人们。上帝与你们同在，你们永远的青海。
921地震的当天的早上，我接到 青海湖上师从国外打来的电话，他说他已经打了，一两个钟头的电话都打不通，啊，结果打通我那一通电话，请你帮助我，这个赶快成立救灾，需要帮助的这个地方，你们赶快去帮助他们，无论在各方面，集合大家的力量，赶快去帮助，就接到青海湖上师的这个关心台湾的这个灾情。
福尔摩沙会员接获指示，立刻组织挖土机、吉普车机动车队及医疗团队，并配备无线电通讯系统，亲自将数车的食物、民生用品、数千个帐篷等紧急救援物资，连同会员捐款共近2000万元，于第一时间运送到南投灾区最前线及相关政府单位。有鉴于921地震所造成的重大损失，为了因应天然灾害并且防患于未然，国家灾害防治法在2001年3月正式成立。法案中规定，要有专业执照的救难人员才能进入灾区执行及时的救援工作。于是青海无上师世界会在2001年正式成立救援队、医疗队及心灵团队，希望结合世界会的所有专业医疗物资采购及心理咨商人员，以发挥政府及民间的力量，全力配合国家紧急救灾策略，不仅提供医疗救助及后勤物资的支援外，并帮助灾民做心灵重建的工作。日前，来自于世界会福尔摩沙全省的会员们接受由国家委托台大医学院所举办的一系列后援配合调度的训练课程。负责主持这一项国家灾害防治训练的国家医疗救难团队石富源医师表示，
我想说国家灾害防治法对一个国家来说事实上是非常非常重要，因为灾难应变呢不是一个部门的工作，它事实上是要整合整个社会各个机构一起的事情。那我想说在这方面，我想这工作本身是一个发挥爱心的工作，所以说我们对他要求就是除了爱心之外，我想说还是爱心的。比如说红十字会他们是长期都有在参与我们的工作，那另外青海湖上师他们也非常热心参与我们的活动，那我也是提供相当多教育性机会给他们，那他们的毕业程度也非常好，也非常认真的学习，实际上我们都非常感激他们。那我们希望说能够有更多的社会的机构能够来参与，大家一起来合作，这样以后我们在台湾才真的能够远离这些灾难的这些危险。
另外，由青海无上师世界会会员所组成的无上师救援协会，更安排专业结绳、攀岩、垂直下降、水中救人等一系列基础、进阶、白天及夜间的训练课程，所有的训练人员都全数通过体能、智力及专业训练，并顺利取得灾区救援执照。2002年2月24日，无上师救援协会正式成立大会，在台北国宾饭店隆重举行。陈水扁总统及立法院长王金平也致函表示祝贺。救援协会希望结合政府与民间的力量，全力配合国家紧急救灾策略，提供第一线的救灾援助。
在大理风灾，我们都真正见识到我们港西救难艇的伟大功能。在当天的时候，那天晚上，我们救难艇就部署在我们西部地区水患最严重、最低洼的地区，南街，在水患就是最严重的6小时当中，在陆续救出了30-40个人其中好像在一个铁皮屋工厂里面，那个水淹一直到五步了它里面困了5个人我们救援队的工人呢，那个救援艇接近之后就绑绳索潜水进去。另外在环线那边有一个孕妇，大陆的孕妇， 困难的时候，我们带很少孩子正在训练。那我们训练体制接近之后，就用人像接骨的把那孕妇接出来。那个孕妇啊，事后回忆啊，感激涕零啊，谢谢你们。会将这个我们这个在大一中带啊，卫协会在救难的一些具体的事迹啊，有呈报到我们基隆市政府啊。那当时的市长李庆勇先生呢、啊，特地在文化中心呢、啊、表扬感谢我们所有的救难人员。
无上师救援协会是灾害防治法实施以来第一支荣获消防署认证的救援队伍，桃枝、娜丽以及日前的敏都丽与艾丽台风期间，无上师救援协会在汐止、桃园、南投、新竹等受创最严重的地区，成功地完成多次救援及补给任务，也特别受到媒体及政府单位的重视。
这次的台风啊，非常谢谢救援协会人啊，特别派来这边来帮助我们。我们基隆市啊，南投社区的上次像我们台风，上次台风因为水灾造成相当多的这个财产、人上的损失啊，所以我们就是特别需要啊，特别帮忙。
好，感谢感谢，
谢谢。
哦，您来问的嘛，给我安排。
有一些民众可能受困，或是说有一些地方他物资没有到达，然后那个现在就是要请那个这个救援学会那个帮我们送这些物资到尖石乡公所，然后做一个那个物资的那个集中，然后由尖石乡公所他把这些物资再分送到需要的地方这样子。
我们在这一次可以说是在我60年来是第一次碰到的一个最大的一个灾难了哈，那所以在这里我们也非常感谢哈这个民间机构哈啊发挥爱心啊，在这样非常不稳定的这个天气之下，还能把物资救援物资送到我们这个灾区来啊，尤其是我们这一次的救援协会。哦，他们不怕所有的困难，哦，也就到达我们这个灾区。
感谢全国各界对这次我们南投县遭受七号水灾大力的监督跟帮忙哦，让我们变到整个救灾工作非常能够非常顺利的展开哈。那我们尤其我们要感谢台北无上师车队哈，在昨天给我们支援我们路况最差最冷运补青睐村我们车子运补工作。那我们今天也是一样，要请他们给我们帮忙。最迅速最快的方式，这样全国各地的民众的爱心监督能够最及时接送到需要的那个灾民手中。我们再次感谢上帝的帮忙。
那要真的要好好保护这个地球，不然以后这个真的又可能没有资源可以利用。然后我觉得去到山上看那些哇，那些房子啊，淹得被土是淹得，可以想象当时那种很惨痛的那种经验。
感谢师父，感谢上帝，让我们今天的工作能够顺利圆满成功。谢谢师父，谢谢上帝，
谢谢师父，感谢上帝，任务完成，拜拜。
这支由青海无上师世界会会员所组成的专业救援团队，队员全部吃素，而且女性队员比例高达1/4，同样接受严格的体能及技术训练，堪称阴阳平均的一支救援队伍。希望将修行的爱心、奉献的精神化作关怀社会的实际行动。
啊，今天呢、啊，是我们中华两栖协会啊成军以来，可以说啊第一次一个实力的展现啊，让我们呢、啊、社会上各阶层的人士对我们中华两栖协会的各位英勇弟兄啊，获得了更大的一个肯定。从刚才各位整个演练的过程，我可以讲，以一个专业人士的角度，我跟各位可以提供4个字：无懈可击啊，无懈可击。
那我们刚刚看到我们
们中华两栖救援队在整个成军典礼的各种的操演上，我们真的给各位非常大的一个肯定啊。那么各位从事救难之工是默默的在工作，我们是人家发生灾难是从灾难里面跑出来，而各位是从各自己聚集在一起而往灾难里面冲。所谓是解人希望是天使，救人苦难是菩萨，这样的各位既是天使也是菩萨。
就是因为有师父的支持，所以无形之中我认为就是说，只要我们有这种勇气想要去参与的话，我们就真的可以达到。即使就是说年纪已经五十几了，但是呢，因为无形中的那种力量一直支持着我们，让我们有这种信心跟勇气继续走下去。最重要就是有一点点爱心，当我们看到别人的苦的时候，我们受不了，所以我们就想要说走出来去帮助救援这种工作。
救援是真爱跟奉献的一种工作。那关于真爱与奉献呢？我们在这儿也要引用净海无上师，师父引导世界进入新纪元演讲里面的一段话。师父说，只要活着一天，我们就应该奉献自己。为了全人
类 ，to the goodness, to the progress of mankind, of the whole world, of the whole universe.Our vision must be so large, larger than life, must be so noble that we have nothing else to lose. We fear nothing in such greatness of a vision.
七海无上师秉持着自幼对灵性的衷心渴求，引领着他以不同的方式侍奉上帝。青年时移居欧洲留学，继而投入国际红十字会担任义务护理人员及翻译。当时他察觉到苦难存在于各种文化和世界各个角落，因此为世界苦难寻求解脱之道便成为他一生的目标。随后七海无上师便展开求道之旅，最后他在印度的喜马拉雅山深处找到一位开悟的名师，传给他观音法门，一个静观内在光和音的打坐法门。经过一段时间精进修行之后，他便达到完全证悟的境界。在他离开喜马拉雅山后不久，基于世界各地追求真理的人们恳求，青海无上师慈悲地与大众分享宝贵的观音法门，鼓励人们往内寻找自己伟大的本性。
During our life, we should raise our consciousness into a more noble aim, helping others to know God, helping others in need. We're busy just to exist here, and we forgot that the source of our strength, the source of our blessing, the source of our richness is within us. And once we can get hold of the source, we will have everything. We are really something.Very, very precious, and it is rightly so, because all the scripture told us that we are the children of God. We can train ourselves to have to think loving, kindness, and positive as much as possible. I only come to tell you that God is gracious, God is loving, God is all forgiving, and if you want to know this God, I can show you.
社会各阶层的人士都发觉，经由修行观音法门，他们的生活变得更圆满、和平与喜乐。不久，欧、美、亚、澳、非各大洲及联合国均多次邀请青海无上师前往讲经。
The peace and love that we most often talk about and seek, we have within ourselves.
Mais le conséquent, c'est pas pareil. Es ist nur eine ununterbrochene Anstrengung.
The future is in our hands.
So you make it beautiful or you make it worse. It's up to you.
青海无上师是当代默默真诚奉献的伟人之一，他帮助人们寻回并创造自己美丽的未来。历史上的伟人都曾有过自己的梦想，青海无上师也不例外。他说
I dream that all the world will become peaceful. I dream that all the killing will stop. I dream that all the children will walk in peace and harmony. I dream that all the nationShake hands with each other, protect each other, and help each other. I dream that our beautiful planet will not be destroyed. It takes billion, billion, trillions of years to produce this planet, and it's so beautiful, so wonderful. I dream that it will continue, but in peace, beauty, and love. Yeah, that is my dream.